Hello, my friend.
How are you, my friend?
How are you? I'm fine, thank you.
Yeah, I'm
How
good
are
too.
You?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm good.
Okay. Yeah. Where are you now?
I'm at home.
Netherlands.
Yeah, I will fly this evening.
Mm-hmm.
So this is my last few hours in Holland, and after I go to Italy.
Okay. Jadi, I try to translate for Boboto, okay?
Yeah.
Jadi Jeffrey sekarang mau berangkat menuju Itali. Okay. First of all, I would like say thanks to you for joining.
Yeah, no problem, no problem. Always fun, no?
You look so happy today.
Yeah, I'm always happy.
Of course, you should. I want to ask some question to you.
Yeah.
How situation in Netherlands for football, for everything?
Yeah, only the professional football is playing.
Mm-hmm.
So only the first two leagues are playing here, and mm-hmm. Everything else stopped mm-hmm. Because of the corona.
Okay.
You have like a curfew, so you can't go after 9 o'clock in the night.
Mm-hmm.
You can go outside, and mm-hmm. like the shopping malls and everything is closed. So.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Jadi Boboto, kata Jeffrey Castillion, di Belanda itu memang sekarang beberapa tempat tutup karena pandemi. Cuman yang aktif beraktivitas itu seperti sepak bola profesional dan hal-hal yang benar-benar urgensinya tinggi. Tapi untuk semua hal-hal yang tidak terlalu penting, pemerintah menutupnya untuk mencegah penyebaran virus. Begitu. So, you ready to play football again after almost 1 year?
Yeah, no. It's, you know, it's been a long time that I play a real match. Like, I played like friendly matches.
Mm-hmm.
But, yeah, now we play for the real thing again. So, I'm happy with this mm-hmm. opportunity.
Yeah.
That I can play for 5 months, and hopefully mm-hmm. In July we can play in Indonesia again.
Of course, we're waiting for you.
Yeah, so for me it's also good that I play games and hopefully I stay fit, and then I come mm-hmm. back really strong to start with Persib again.
Yeah, you should. Jadi, Boboto, yes. Si kompetisi di Indonesia seperti kita tahu kan, sudah terhenti lama, dan Jeffrey juga merasakan ada perbedaan dari segi persiapan. Nah, sekarang buat Castillion sendiri merupakan kesempatan yang bagus katanya, karena dia akan bermain kurang lebih selama 5 bulan di satu kompetisi di negara sepak bolanya yang juga bagus. Jadi itu juga bagus untuk dirinya pribadi, dan dia sangat berharap setelah dari Como nanti bisa kembali lagi ke Indonesia bermain lagi untuk Persib. Dan dia lebih kuat lagi dan lebih bagus lagi performanya bersama Persib. Doakan saja Boboto. Gitu. So, how about your preparation for playing football game?
Yeah, I was like, I feel like a personal coach here in Holland. So, mm-hmm. since I'm in Holland, I'm training with him. But it's not really football training, a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
But more like for the fitness.
Mm-hmm.
So my fitness is good, only like the playing rhythm I miss a little bit. But I think when I train in Italy with the team, this will come maybe in 1-2 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's my preparation.
Mm-hmm.
Then I hope that I can be important for this team, because mm-hmm. they play for promotion and I want to help them. So. Mm-hmm. I think it's like a win-win situation. I can play. I will be fit and strong for Persib again, and I can help the team in Italy.
So. Okay. Jadi begitu katanya Boboto. Sebelum ke Italia, Castillion sudah melakukan persiapan yang cukup matang, karena di Belanda juga Castillion punya personal trainer, pelatih pribadi untuk mempersiapkan menuju Como, dan sesekali dia berlatih di lapangan normal untuk menunjang performanya di Italia sana. begitu. Ya dia, ya intinya dia berharap di Italia nanti dia bisa kembali lagi sentuhannya, malah mungkin lebih tajam, agar di Persib jadi lebih bagus lagi. Doakan, oke? Okay? Oke, okay. We have question from Mr. Teddy, our boss. Don't forget to eat pizza there in Italy.
Yeah, I have to. It's not so healthy, so maybe a few times, but not too much.
Mm-hmm. Nah, ya, yeah. Pak Teddy katanya pizza tidak terlalu bagus untuk kesehatan, tapi untuk beberapa kali mah oke lah. Pizza. Gitu. You just play in three match in Indonesia.
Yes, not so much.
Only three match, and you scored. Yeah. 2 goals. Can you describe or explain your experience here in Indonesia?
I think the thing what I liked the most was the supporters, like the fans.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you play the game, there's so much noise. Everybody supports us, and you get to, if you score a goal, they shout so loud, you know, it's really nice. Mm-hmm. And I think for us as team, we get really a lot of energy of it.
Mm-hmm.
So I think this is the, I only had experiences for 2 home games, but I hope this year it will be much more.
Yeah, we hope so. Yeah, yes. Jadi Bapak tahu katanya, Dari tiga pertandingan saja, Jeffrey sudah mendapatkan pengalaman yang sangat luar biasa. Terutama ketika riuh suara Boboto. Dan dia cuma bermain 2 kali di Liga di depan Boboto. Tapi dia sudah merasakan energi yang luar biasa karena ketika dia mencetak gol, riuhnya itu luar biasa menurut Jeffrey. Dan itu salah satu pengalaman yang menjadi pengalaman yang luar biasa bagi Jeffrey dalam hidupnya. Seperti itu. So, what's your memorable moments in Indonesia?
I think my first goal in the league. Mm-hmm. Because I didn't know what to expect, and you know, my first time in Asia in Indonesia. Mm-hmm. And then the first game of the league is always important. Mm-hmm. So I think when I scored the first goal of the season for our team, this was special for me. That's why I was best so happy also, you can see.
Best memorable in from 3 match.
From 3 match, yes.
Only 3 match. Yeah. Jadi katanya yang paling berkesan, yang benar-benar diingat Jeffrey, itu saat dia mencetak gol pertama untuk Persib di kompetisi resmi. Karena ya itu pun merupakan karirnya yang pertama di benua Asia bagi seorang Jeffrey Castillo. Jadi momen itu sangat tidak terlupakan. Begitu. So, Jeffrey, how about Indonesian climate? You have easy for adaptation or not?
No, it was not easy.
Mm-hmm.
I think it was like 1 month or 2 months before I was really adapting to the climate. Mm-hmm. In the beginning, it was really heavy for me because it's really hot there, and like the air is really thick. It's not like Europe. So mm-hmm. when you run, it was really heavy for me.
but you pass it,
of course. Yeah. And with the jet lag, the time difference was also not easy because mm-hmm. I was sleeping in the day and then awake in the night for like 2 weeks, I think, also like that. So mm-hmm. the beginning was really tough, but after that, it was good, no problem. Nah.
Jadi katanya di Indonesia sendiri, Jeffrey Castillion cukup kesusahan untuk beradaptasi dengan suhu karena sebelumnya dia merupakan pemain yang bermain di Liga Islandia yang memiliki suhu yang sangat dingin. Terus dia juga merupakan pemain yang asli dari Belanda yang mempunyai suhu udara cukup dingin juga. Dia mengatakan untuk berlari saja di Indonesia ini cukup sulit, tapi dengan usahanya yang keras dia bisa melewati itu semua. Bahkan dia sampai pertama kali dua minggu pertama di Indonesia, Jeffrey kesulitan mengatur pola tidurnya. Begitu. Oke, what's your hope for Indonesian football or Indonesian league?
Yeah, I hope that we can start this year. You know, it's a long time now that we stopped. And you can see it in other countries that they are playing also. So I think there must be a solution to.
Yes, of course.
To play the league, but it has to be safe, and because the corona is really important, of course. Mm-hmm. But I think there's a solution to play this year, and I hope they will find it soon, and that we can start the preseason. Because, yeah, for me now, I can play somewhere else, but other players are still at home, so I think everybody wants to play again.
Mm-hmm. Ya, pokoknya Castillion berharap si kompetisi ini bisa berjalan lagi, tapi dengan syarat tetap menjaga kesehatan, karena si corona sendiri kan kita tahu virus yang sangat berbahaya. Semoga ya semuanya bisa berjalan lancar di setelahnya. Jeffrey, have you choose number at Como? Number 20 or different number?
Yeah, no, I said to the team manager, I said if 20 is available, I will take 20. And yeah, otherwise I will play with number 30.
Okay. So, jadi kalau ada nomor 20, Jeffrey pakai nomor 20. Iya, iya, iya. Oke. Do you have a message for our supporter?
Yes, of course. I will miss Boboto, of course. I will be away only for 5-6 months, and then I will come back and fight for Persib again. And
you promise, yeah?
Yeah, of course.
Of course.
And, we're gonna fight for the champions ship this year.
Okay. Okay. Now we give an opportunity to our Boboto to asking some question for you, okay?
Yeah.
Okay. Ya, silakan Boboto. Kalau ada yang mau ditanyakan, bahkan barangkali ada yang penasaran. Oh, ada Mali Bojan. Bojan Malisik. Hello, Mali. How are you? I'm good. We are good here. We wait. Malisik, our former defender. 2018. Uh-huh. Yes. One question from Boboto. Have you played in Eredivisie?
Yeah, I played there for 3 years.
Oh, okay. So, which club?
But I played for RKC, Waalwijk, and NEC Nijmegen, Heracles Almelo, and one game for Ajax Amsterdam.
Oof, amazing. Perfect. Okay, wait for another question. Ayo, ada yang mau bertanya lagi? Pernah main di Liga Belanda 3 tahun di 5 klub tadi, termasuk Ajax Amsterdam. Jeffrey, how many goals will you score in Como? Have you predict? your target.
I don't know. I will try my best, of course, and I always want to score goals, and we will see in the end, but I hope many as possible.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Okay, good. One Boboto request to you for speaking Sundanese. Only one word. Only one word. Yes.
Kuma Adamang.
Okay, we are good. Thank you. Kuma Adamang katanya. Okay, we wait for another questions. Yeah. Wait. Ah, someone asking, do you miss Bandung City or Indonesia?
Yes, of course. I think the most important is the weather, because here it's really cold.
Yes.
But, it was nice, the weather in Bandung, mm-hmm. and I only don't miss the traffic. Mm-hmm. It's a lot of traffic, so I don't like to be.
I don't like to. I don't
too long in the car is not good. So, but the weather was really nice, so I missed that. Yeah, and okay. The food, of course.
Ah, oke. Okay. Ya, jadi Jeffrey katanya sangat senang ada di Bandung, rindu di Bandung karena suhunya juga sangat bagus, situasinya sangat bagus, tapi dia tidak suka dengan macetnya kota Bandung. Dia bilang sangat tidak bagus berada di mobil lama-lama dengan kemacetan yang luar biasa. Gitu katanya Boboto. Status pinjam atau pindah? Peminjaman 5 bulan sampai bulan Juli. Wait. Waiting for last question maybe. Okay. Wait. Do you have favorite food in Indonesia?
Nasi goreng.
Nasi goreng, of course. Yeah. Nasi goreng. We also like.
Nasi goreng.
Nasi goreng, okay. Okay, my friend. Thank you for this good opportunity. We are so pleasure to meet you.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
I will be back soon.
Of course, we're waiting for you here. Okay, see you soon in Bandung. Stay hard, stay strong, and help Como to promotion.
Yeah, this was been nice.
Okay.
Thank you, my friend.
Once again. Okay, thank you well.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye. See you.